asked to do a TEDx talk, the first question I got, why me? What message am I going to share? And the answer I got was, because all your students, regardless of whether they were good at math before or not, end up enjoying math once they have you as a teacher. How do you do that? I teach math, one of the most loved or hated subjects. And the general perception is that math is not for everyone, but most post-secondary programs require it. Although I could see the impact I have on the students once I have taught them, I was not able to articulate what I was doing differently. So I went on Facebook and posted the following. To all my students, I would really appreciate if you can send me a few words describing what you still remember about my work with you as a person or as a group. I was truly surprised, firstly, by how many comments I received, but most importantly, by how much the students still remember. Here are three examples. This is Sarah, 1998. I remember students shocking themselves by how easily they grasped concepts delivered by you, even after they gave up on the subject altogether. You made those who hate math love it, and those who love it even more. This is Judy in 2012. We always got a lot of work done, and it never felt like painful work. Your classes were consistently entertaining and productive. I was always surprised by the amount of knowledge I acquired from your classes. That is why I never missed skip classes. And I still wish you were my teacher at college. This is Najat. Every question was welcomed because no question was stupid. On the contrary, you used it as an example to explain a point to the whole class. Clearly, you cared more about the students learning rather than completing the lesson. And for that, I'm personally grateful. I truly believe that the drive I have in my teaching is due to the fact that I was denied my own personal goal when I was a student. And as a teacher, I want to make sure that my students do not suffer a similar experience. I would like to share with you a story about a student named Jane. Jane was a happy teenager who enjoyed spending time with her friends, was excited about school, did well in all the subjects except math. Math was a very big source of frustration and insecurity for her because she was just not good at it. I had Jane in grade 9. She was 14 years old. Every year, the teachers have an informal get-together where they sit and discuss students' weaknesses and strengths. This is a practice that I do not put much emphasis on because I think that the students should have a fresh start at the beginning of every school year. They should be given the opportunity to create their own self-image. Nothing can be more uncomfortable than being labeled. She's not good in math, he doesn't do his assignment, she's not attentive, and I can go on. Labels are easy to carry and very hard to shake. When it came to Jane, the head of department declared that there is not much anyone can do to help her because she simply doesn't have the proper skills to process math. When I met Jane, she was quiet and shy and did not express herself. And yet, she had a spark in her eye which made me believe that she could do math. But Jane did not believe that she could do math, despite her psychoeducational assessment, which showed that she has good math skills and reasoning abilities. I was hopeful at the beginning of the year that Jane will do good. But in December, I was shocked. She failed her December exams by getting a 40%. I felt so responsible. She failed a subject that every student should pass. We're talking about high school math, and all around the world, math is a core subject, so in theory, every student should be able to pass math. Contrary to popular belief, math is not only for smart people. Math is a subject built on connections and applying problem-solving strategies. I do not give up on my students and would have never given up on Jane because I feel that it is my role as a teacher to help the students achieve their goals. I know what it means to strive for a dream and not achieve it. I myself was lucky to be in one of the best schools in my home country of Lebanon. We had the most knowledgeable teachers. I was an excellent student throughout middle school. But in high school, I started struggling in subjects such as languages and social studies. I felt that the teachers gave up on me, but I don't even recall them trying. However, one subject I was really good at was mathematics. In math, I was an A-plus student throughout high school, until I reached grade 11. In grade 11, at the age of 17, I could no longer depend on my natural abilities to carry me throughout the course material. The curriculum required deeper understanding and more analysis. And because I was a quiet and introverted student, perhaps I did not express myself enough and ask for help when I needed support. I needed a safe environment where I can take risks solving problems, where I can ask for more reasoning, where I can be given justifications for wrong answers. Unfortunately, the teachers did not support my needs. My grades started deteriorating, and I barely got through the course. What is the point of being in an excellent school with such knowledgeable teachers who won't connect and reach out to their students? The school system failed me. And by doing somewhat well only in one subject, closed so many doors. By doing poorly in other subjects, I could no longer follow my childhood passion in becoming an architect. At university, I was only able to study mathematics. Although I did not end up being an architect, I was lucky to end up being the teacher of a subject that I love, and eventually be able to make a difference in the lives of the students. My goal was to help the students reach their goals. I want them to end up with open options. I don't want them to lose their career options. So how do I run my classes to reach my goals? I would like to mention four things. First and foremost, I make a conscious effort in creating a comfortable and safe learning environment. When the students feel comfortable in an environment that is supportive, they will be open up for me to help them and support them and challenge them in the math world. In class, they talk, they argue, they agree, they disagree, they object freely, as long as it is math related. They feel that the class is their space, not my space. And when the students feel comfortable asking, they will start taking risks and thinking outside of the box. I encourage them to question everything and never to take things for granted. I do not give them answers. I do not give them hints. I guide them with questions, and they build on each other's solutions and problem-solving strategies. In effect, what I'm really doing is teaching them how to appreciate math, giving them enough tools to have control over the subject, and wanting to learn more, rather than simply wanting to get through the course material. Second, I see my students as humans with good intentions who want to succeed. And this is the foundation of trust between us. Any behavioral problem could be solved by communication and never should be blown out of proportion. Arriving late, forgetting their material, chatting in class, for me, all these are minor issues and should not affect my relationship with the students. Third, I try to see and understand my students from a human perspective. For instance, some students are quiet and introverted. And often when the students do not express themselves, the teachers assume that they are not processing information. But because I myself was a quiet student, I know that this is not true. If we do not express ourselves loudly, it does not mean that we're not thinking. Fourth, we live in a society that puts a lot of emphasis on grades, and the students are pressured to get high marks. So as a teacher, should I teach the students how to get high marks, or should I encourage their love of learning and build their confidence in the subject matter? I think that if I can pique their curiosity in the subject, they will be motivated enough to do math, and eventually the grades will follow. And now let's go back to Jane. After Jane failed her midterm exam, I was determined to help her. I saw myself in Jane, and I didn't want her to feel unheard, unseen, or uncared for. So I started clearing up the gaps that she accumulated over the years. I stayed with her after school. I replied to all her emails, even if it meant staying up very late at night. I interacted discreetly with her in class, so when I used to see her doodling, I asked her a question to bring her back to the lesson. As her understanding and appreciation for math improved, so did her confidence. And gradually, Jane felt less insecure and frustrated about her math abilities, and her grades got really better. If Jane did not have a teacher in grade 9 which believed in her, she would have given up on math, and her career options would have been very limited. But there is a happy ending. Jane is now in college, and she is in the program of her choice. After graduation, Jane wrote me a letter saying, "I used to think I was not very intelligent when it came to math, but you were able to change the way I think of myself, and that made a big difference. The fact that you thought I could do it made me think I could do it. Without what you saw in me, I would not be here today in commerce at Marianopolis doing the program of my choice and doing well in math." So if now I go back to the comments that the students wrote on Facebook and reflect on them, I will be able to articulate what I'm doing differently. As a teacher, I kept the student in me alive. I teach with the heart of a student, but with the mind of a teacher. Thank you.